Good morning, children. Let's start today's class. Children, in the last class we started noun. So in today's class we will do its exercise part. But before that, let us recapitulate. What is a noun? A noun is a word used as the name of a person, place or a thing. So let us see what are the types of noun. First is your common noun. So common noun is the name given in common to every person, thing of the same class or a kind. Proper noun is the name of some particular person or place. What is collective noun? Collective noun is the name of a number of person or things that are taken together and spoken of as one whole. Then we have abstract noun, which is the name of a quality, action or state. Material noun is the name of a substance from which an object is formed. Then we have also seen another classification of noun, that is countable and uncountable noun. So countable nouns are the names of objects, people, etc. that you can count, whereas uncountable nouns are the names of things which we cannot count. Okay, so let's start with the exercise. Question number 1. Underline all the nouns in the following sentences and put them under the right groups given below. So in this question, what you have to find out? You have to find out the nouns and its types in the given sentences, and then after that you have to place them in this given box. So let's do that. Question number 1. Anu likes bananas, oranges and apples. So here we have noun Anu, bananas, oranges and apples. So Anu is a proper noun, whereas bananas, oranges and apples are common noun. Next we have, my father visited London in England and New York in USA. So here father is your common noun, whereas London, England, New York and USA are the example of proper noun. Why? Because they indicate or they are used for a particular place. Okay, same as here, the gateway of India is in Mumbai. So these two are the name of particular place. So gateway of India and Mumbai are the example of proper noun. Ornaments are made of gold, silver and brass. So here ornaments is the collection. So this is your collective noun, whereas gold, silver and brass, they are the type of material noun. Bricks, cement, wood and iron are used to build houses. So here bricks, cement, wood and iron are the example of material noun, whereas house is common noun. Good health brings happiness. So here happiness is noun, but what type of noun this is? As it represent feeling or quality, so it will come under abstract noun. Okay, let's see the next one. Question number 7. Hari saw zebra, giraffe, lion and rhino in the zoo. So Hari is your proper noun, whereas the name of these animals will come under common noun. Let's see the next one. The school invited a band of musicians and a troupe of dancers on its annual day function. So here school will come under common noun because the name of the school is not given. So it will come under common noun. Band is your, it's a group. So that will come under collective noun. Your musicians will come under common noun. Troop is again a group. So it will come under collective noun. Dancers will come under common noun. Okay, let's see the next one. The question number 9. The herd of elephants was seen near the rivers. So here herd is a collection, so this will come under collective noun. Elephants common noun, and river also will come under common noun. It's talking about a general river, so that will come under common noun. Next we have question number 10. Indians wish love, brotherhood, peace and prosperity on festivals like Eid, Diwali and Christmas. So here Indians, as we are talking about the citizens of a particular country, so it will come under proper noun. Love, brotherhood, peace and prosperity, they represent quality, so that will come under abstract noun. And as Eid, Diwali and Christmas are the names of festivals, so that will come under proper noun. Is it clear? Okay, so question number 2 is your homework. Here what is this question? Here some nouns are given. You have to divide them in countable and uncountable in green color. As ear, can you count ear? No, it is an example of uncountable noun. Orange you can count, so that will come under countable. Books you can count, that will also come under countable. Coffee, can you count? No, that will come under uncountable. So in this manner you have to do this exercise, question number 2. Okay, let's move to the next one. Here one activity is given. So what you have to do, fill in the blanks with the abstract nouns of the following words. Some words are given in the box. You have to write them in these blanks. Okay. The dash of Mount Everest is 8,848 meters. So what will come here? Height. Height is given here, but you have to write in abstract form. So height will change into height. The height of Mount Everest is 8,848 meters. Let's see the next one. Many people die of dash in Ethiopia. So here the word is starve. What will come here? Starvation. Many people die of starvation in Ethiopia. Let's see the next one. She secured marks beyond her expectations. Expect is given here, so you have to change it into abstract form. So expectations will come here. The mischievous boy was given here. Punish is given, so what will come? Punishment. Dash is good for health. Laugh, so you have to change that into abstract noun. So laugh will become laughter. Laughter is good for health. Dash is next to godliness. What will come here? Here clean is given. So its abstract form will be cleanliness. Cleanliness is next to godliness. Okay, let's see question number 7. Solomon was known for his, we have wise here, so change it into abstract. So what will come? Wisdom. Solomon was known for his wisdom. The dash of radium has proved very useful. So we have the word discover for it. So when you write its abstract form, that will change into discovery. The discovery of radium has proved very useful. The best period of one's life is, what will come? Here we have young, so its abstract form will be youth. The best period of one's life is youth. Next we have question number 10. She is still a girl. She has not yet entered into, here we have woman. So you have to change it into abstract, so it will become womanhood. So she is still a girl. She has not yet entered into womanhood. Okay, let's do question number B. Fill in the blanks with suitable nouns from the box. You have to select the nouns from this box and you have to fill this blanks. Let's start. I would like to buy a bunch of what? From the fruit stall. A bunch of grapes. I fell on a heap of dash on the beach. We say heap of sand. We have to select sand from here and white sand here. A herd of what was grazing in the field. So what will come? A herd of cows. Shipra saw a pride of lions in the Gir sanctuary. The dash ranges were covered with snow. What will come? Mountain ranges. The government formed a panel of dash to judge the quality. So panel of expert, as it is a collective noun, so what will come here? A panel of expert. The grocer kept the clutch of dash very carefully on the shelf. So what will come here? Eggs. A flock of pigeons was pecking at the bird seed on the ground. A pack of what will come? Wolves. A pack of wolves gathered around the terrified girl. The company of dash was sitting in the theater green room. So the last one which is left here is actors. So the company of actors was sitting in the theater green room. So children, is it clear? Okay, now you do this exercise in your book. Thank you.